Mouser Blues fans, the riots in Turkey are still going on right now at this moment. In fact, after the main event, which happened several days ago, protesters returned to the square to actually clean up. Now, this situation is actually starting to grow. It's actually starting to become a bigger deal and spreading not just from Istanbul, but starting to surround the popular consciousness of people around the city as well, threatening to possibly engulf the entire country if the situation is not taken care of. Meanwhile, the government of Turkey has decided that they're going to label the people who protested as marauders, as terrible people that are just trying to tear apart the nation. Now, in a good sign, those not actually even engaged in violent conflict with the state have come up with their own form of protest as well. Thus far, violence from the government has injured over 1,000 people, and at least as of this recording, it's known about 2 people that have been killed. Now, an interesting phenomenon here is that while these riots have been going on, there have been a lot of stores, like small mom-and-pop type stores, and regular people offering food, water, shelter, and sometimes medical care for people involved in this struggle. So we can see that this isn't just strictly limited to the lowest of the lowest class. People who are in slightly higher classes from the actual bottom are involved in this as well, and that this isn't just something that exists in one radical group or one group of troublemakers, as the government asserts. This is clearly something that exists within the consciousness of the people itself, as we can see that despite these slight class differences, they are working very well together as one against the actions of this government. The communists in Turkey are also playing a very large role in the ongoing protests. To give credibility to this, the police raided the offices of the Communist Party of Turkey at 11 p.m. on June 2nd, trashing the offices and destroying a great deal of property. The party has been actively involved in the ongoing riots against the crumbling religious government. With no fear in their hearts, the communists took to the streets and actively engaged in combat with the police, enduring fire hoses and beatings. Day by day, this situation is getting worse. What we are seeing here is an acute form of the contradiction between capital and labor. The ruling class within Turkey and its own interests that are in contradiction to those of the working class are really coming to a head here. One of the main things behind this is the ruling class's endorsement of radical Islamist policies. And Turkey has always been known to be a really very secular state, and now this party, the ruling party, is now trying to undo that, and has put forward a lot of things that would squash secular ideas, some very reactionary ideas around some very Islamist kind of things, like making it more difficult to purchase alcohol and stuff like that. Now, it's what we're seeing is a popular resistance to that. The contradictions between the ruling classes and the people is starting to come to a head now more than ever. you know, what we have is, you know, where it's now trying to meet its own ambitions that go against the will of the people, like its ongoing support for the FSA terrorists in Syria that are backed by NATO, and allowing the country to be used by NATO to funnel weapons and support to the FSA. This is not strictly caused by the FSA, but this is certainly a contributing factor to the overall exploding social situation in the country.